Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. I hope you are doing well. Today's video, I'm so excited because we are doing another holiday makeup look. Yay! Who is excited about that? Because I'm so excited to make them. I've been doing few of them lately. One was a monochromatic berry look. Another one was more like an emerald green eye look. But today, I wanted to keep it a proper classic holiday makeup look with the red lipstick and this bronzy goddess eyelid. I know some of you may not like crazy eye look and still want this red lipstick, so this is what I'm doing today for you guys. I'm bringing on a classic holiday makeup look, plus I'm so excited because we are using my favorite product at the moment. But not just, I'm also including in this video few makeup I got during the Black Friday. So if you want to see how I create this look right here, a classic holiday makeup look using my favorite products and new ones as well, just keep on watching. Gosh, it's so cold outside. We are nearly 0 degrees. Can you believe that? We are actually two degrees right now when I'm talking to you, and it's so cold, my goodness. So let's just get started, shall we? The first thing first, I'm gonna prep my skin. The face mist I'm using is the Body Shop Rose Dewy Glow, because I need my skin to look glowy a little bit but also hydrated, because as I said, it's so cold outside that I need some hydration back to my skin, but also some glowiness, because I feel like my skin is a little bit dull. So this is a really good one to hydrate, refresh and also illuminate your skin. Because my skin needs hydration, I will be using this beauty elixir oil by Kevin Aucoin. It's the No Elixir Weightless Beauty Oil. What this oil will do is it's gonna hydrate your skin, nourishing your skin, but also it's gonna give some glowiness from within, and it's gonna be a good boost of hydration. Because we still want to minimize our pores, but also to blur out and to smooth out fine lines, any texture, this is going to be your best friend. It's the No Problem Primer by Touch and Soul. The texture is very lotiony, very lightweight on the skin. You don't feel it, but it really makes a whole difference by smoothing out your fine lines, your texture, and minimize your pores. It's a really great product. The foundation of choice today is going to be the Born This Way by Too Faced. I have it in the shade Natural Beige. I love this foundation so much. It gives such a radiant skin-like finish, but it's silvery full coverage, but you don't feel it at all on the skin. It doesn't look cakey or masky. It just looks beautiful, and this foundation is amazing, a must-have. I just love it so much. This is also a buildable coverage foundation, so you can have it light, medium, but also full. You really can play with the coverage you want. Look at this radiance to my face. So luminous, so glowy, so healthy. I just love it. And you see, it looks so natural and skin-like as well. It just looks your skin, but better actually. That's why I love this foundation so much. And for concealer, you guessed it right, we are still using the Too Faced Born This Way Concealer, and I have it in the shade Golden Beige. I rave about it way too much, so you know my love for this concealer. And these two together, oh my goodness, match heaven. Obviously, because they are coming from the same line, huh? But it really looks really good together. And those two shades are perfect with each other, seriously. Natural beige for the foundation, golden beige for the concealer, and it looks heaven. And of course, to set my under eye and T-zone, I will be using the Too Faced Born This Way Setting Powder. Yay! Today is the Too Faced Born This Way Foundation Base Routine. I'm gonna bake a little bit, not for too long, a couple of minutes. Then for the rest of my face, I will be setting my face with the Mineralize Skin Finish by MAC in the shade Medium. This is a great powder if you want your face to be set, but also to have this luminous radiant finish to it. This is a really good one for that. I sweep off the excess powder under my eyes and my nose. Then let's talk about new stuff, shall we? Ta-da-da-da! The new MAC Face Contour Highlight Palette. There you go. I got it not long ago, and I'm so happy I got it, because you've got all the shades you need to highlight and contour your face. Oopsie Daisy. That was the little thingy thing plastic with the name on it. This is how this beauty looks like. I'm just so happy. I just love everything about it. I love all the highlight shade. You have the emphasize, very popular and cult on YouTube shade. You have this yellow banana shade, which called cream. Then you've got the accentuate shade, which is like a pinky peach shade as well, but very very light, so it's not like beam on your face. And I love these three shades for highlighting. Then here you have three contour shades. You've got taupe, sculpt and bone base. One has a gray undertone, so perfect for contouring. This one is more like a medium contour shade, and this one is more like a darker shade, so more maybe for bronzing. So I'm gonna be mixing taupe and sculpt to contour my face. You see, that's the perfect contour shade to really chisel your cheekbone and to give dimension and to structure your face. I just love it. The shades are really perfect. And to highlight my under eye, I will be using Emphasize and the Banana Cream shade. Ooh, wow, yes. That we can call it brightening your under eye. Can you see the difference as well? Awake, not awake. Then to bronze my face, I will be using, I know I've been using it quite a lot lately, but I just love that bronzer so much. It's the Anastasia powder bronzer in the shade Cedar. I'm gonna give some warmth back to our face. I want to be bronzy, I want to look good, I want to look healthy, alive, awake. So bronzer it is today. Then for blush, it's still in the box. Yay! A new blush from Anastasia Beverly Hills that I'm gonna be trying today for the first time. You know how much I love my trio blush, the Peachy Love, I believe it calls, from Anastasia. It's very warm, very peachy. But now I've got another one, and it's the blush trio in the Pool Party shades. This calls cold weather, cool tone makeup, winter London makeup. Actually, I think I'm gonna make a winter London makeup look. If you wanna see it, leave me a comment below. I have a vision for a winter London makeup look that I really want to do, but I want to know if you do want to watch this kind of makeup as well. Anyways, back to this beautiful blush. Look at this cool tone blush, a matte pinky shade. You have a shimmery, but not really shimmer, there's just the sparkles of shimmer into this bright pink, and you have this neutral taupey shades, very like for the on-the-go kinda look, very neutral. So I'm so happy about it, it's beautiful. Here's the swatches, the pinky matte shade, the shimmery pinky bold shade, and this one is the neutral shade, matte finish. They're really pretty, yes! So I think today I will be doing a mix between the pinky shade and the neutral shade and see how it goes. They are so pigmented, guys, but they are really beautiful too. It looks like I was having a marathon and I just got home and I have this flesh cheek. Love it. I love this kind of look, seriously. Look at that. Feel awake again. This blush just gives me life. For the most exciting part, the highlighting part, and not any highlighter we're gonna be using today. Another new highlighter, Anastasia Beverly Hills, came out for round 2 with the collaboration with Amrezy, still in the box again because I was waiting to make this video so I can use it for the first time with, yeah, okay, for the first time with you guys. And look at this packaging first of all. This is stunning, gorgeous, and look at the beauty here. Can you see that? Yeah, ta-da, ta-da-da-da. Look at this highlighter, blowing your mind. Christmassy parties, festivities, I'm here for you. Yeah, that was a little song for happiness. Just the package, look at that waves. Yes, thank you Anastasia for bringing it back for the second time. Oh yes, 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 let's... This is a champagne gold shade and this is bling bling, so this is perfect for this time of the year. If you are not very into highlight, but for like festivities, soirées or parties you want to bring, that's your best friend, because this is going to change your whole makeup look, guys. Look at this bling on your face. This is a highlight on Flick for sure. Yes, I'm so happy I finally got my hands on it, because the first time around I missed it. But then surprise, Black Friday, it came back. It wasn't on sale, but it came back. And I don't care, because how gorgeous it is, I can pay full price for this one. Now for the eyes, we're gonna still stay in the Anastasia Beverly Hills family, and of course we're gonna use the one and only Soft Glam eyeshadow palette for this look. What other eyeshadow palette will be the best for a classic holiday makeup look? Of course, the Soft Glam is the one. Before applying the eyeshadow, we're gonna prep our lid, and we're gonna be using the MAC Pro Longwear Pen Pot in Painterly. So the first thing I'm gonna be doing is to use that Tempera shade, which is a light beige cream shade, to set my lid. Then I'm gonna be using Orange Soda into my crease for my transition shade. I'm going back and forth, and then I'm doing circular motion so the color is diffused and well blended. Let me zoom you. Then I'm gonna be using Burnt Orange still into my crease, but I'm gonna deepen up a little bit the color so it has a little bit of a dimension into my crease. Then with the smaller brush, I'm gonna be using Sienna into my outer corner just to defend a little bit more, to make it a little bit more smokier. And I'm following the line of my eye shape. Then I'm back to my fluffy brush with nothing on, and I'm just cleaning up and soften up a little bit the edges to blend everything together. And if you feel like it's a little bit too up to your eyebrow, what you do is you take that light creamy beige shade, which is Tempera, with the bigger brush, and you go above the edges like so to soften up a little bit the arch lines. Then for my eyelid, I'm going back to that Painterly shade. I'm applying it on my eyelid again, because I'm gonna be using one of the shimmery shades from the palette, and I want that shimmer to pop. Then with my finger, I'm gonna be applying Bronze, which is a beautiful gold shimmery shade. Look at this, a bronzy gold shade, perfect for this eye look, seriously. And I'm applying on top of that base. Is beautiful, beautiful, pure gold. Now what I will do, I'll go back to this smaller brush, and I will get Sienna, and I'm going back to the outer corner just to diffuse the outer corner better, and I'm going into the crease like so. So there is no shimmery pigment on above the elbow. Then for my lower lash line, I will be using Burnt Orange and Sienna together. And for my inner corner and my brow bone, I'm going back to that Amrezy beautiful highlighter. I don't know if I'm gonna be using the nude or the brown on my waterline. You know what? I'm gonna be using the nude on my waterline, and I will be using the brown on my lash line. Yeah, I'm gonna do that. The nude is the nude. Oh, c'est pas vrai? They're both from Rimmel. The brown one is the Exaggerate line. It's the rich brown shade. And the nude is from the Scandalize line, and it's the nude shade. Then for my lashes, I will be using the mascara Monsieur Big from Lancome. And for my brow, I will be using the Maybelline Brow Precise Fiber Filler in the shade Medium Brown. Then the fun part, lips. So we're gonna do a beautiful classic red lips, and who else than MAC do the best red lipstick? So this one is going to be Russian Red To accompany this lipstick, I'm gonna be using a lip liner still by MAC, and it's the Brick Lip Liner, and it's a perfect red. It's not too cool tone, it's really the right tone. So let's first apply the lip liner. And when I line my lips, I always filling my lips as well, because it's gonna make your lipstick last longer. Even though this one is a matte lipstick that really lasts for a long time, it always helps a little bit more. So here's with the lip liner on its own. Now, lipstick. But before we are finished with this look, we need to set our face to have our makeup last for all night long, of course. So we are using the Urban Decay All Nighter Makeup Setting Spray Long Lasting. And there you go guys, here's the final makeup look. I'm so excited about this look. I'm so loving how it turned out. Just classic, glam, put together, but still bam in your face with the highlighter, with the red lipstick. Oh my gosh, I love it so much. I love how the eyes is classic, but at the same time very goldish looking, you know, with those shimmer on the eyelid. I'm just loving all the products I use for this look. And if you did like this video, please give a thumbs up. Let me know in the comment below if you want to see more holiday makeup look, because I have still few in mind that I really want to do, but let me know if you want to watch them as well. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already, because I would love to see you again in my next video. And until the next one, stay beautiful. And of course, happy holiday. Bye.